So welcome back to the second part of the video. So next we are going to draw the influence line diagram for the shear force at E. For that, first consider the unit load is in the portion AB. That means 0 less than or is equal to H less than or is equal to L. That means the limits are when X is equal to 0 and when X is equal to L. That means the shear force at E is equal to what we get. That means we are considering the unit load in the span AD and we are going to take the shear force at the point E. So you can see in this figure it is RA minus 1 plus RB. RA minus 1 plus RB is a value of shear force at E. That means RA is L minus H by L minus 1 plus RB is H by L. Then apply the limits, that is when H is equal to 0, we get F is equal to 0. When H is equal to L, we also get F is equal to 0. Okay, that means the value of FV at both the points 0 and L is 0. So that we can draw the influence line diagram for FE as like this. When H is equal to 0, the value of FE is 0, and when H is equal to L, the value of FE is 0. So that it is a straight line. Okay, then consider the unit load in the portion BE. That means the Z less than or is equal to H less than or is equal to A. So the value of shear force at A is RA plus RB minus 1. Okay, it is again we get the value as 0. Okay, so that for the span BE it is also A 0. Then consider the unit load in the portion EC. That means 0 less than or is equal to H less than or is equal to Z. Then take the value of shear force at E. So this is a figure. That means the unit load in the span EC. So by using this figure, we can easily locate or easily find out the value of shear force at E. It is 1 kilonewton positive. So that the value of influence line diagram at the point C is 1. Okay. So this is the influence line diagram for shear force at E. Now we have to draw the shear force influence line diagram for the bending moment at D. Okay. For that, we have to find out the various values of moments at D when the unit load is moving from starting point to the end point. That means from the first span to the last span. Okay, that means this is the first figure. That means the unit load is in the span AD. Then we have to find out the value of bending moment at the point D. Okay, it is simply RB into L minus Z. So this is the length Z and this distance is L minus Z. Okay, so RB into L minus Z is the moment at D. Since it is in anti-clockwise direction, it is positive. So you got the value of moment at D as S by L into L minus Z. Okay, then apply the limits. When H is equal to 0, MD equal to 0. When H is equal to Z, MD equal to Z into L minus Z by L. Okay, both are positive value. So we can draw the influence line diagram for MD as when H is equal to 0, MD is 0, and when H is equal to Z, MD is Z into L minus Z by L. Okay, so this is the influence line diagram for the first part. Then consider the unit load in the portion DB. That means MD equal to RA into Z. By refer this figure, you got the same. Okay, RA into Z, that means L minus H by L into Z. Then apply the limits, that is when H is equal to Z, MD equal to L minus Z by L into Z. So here we got the same value, L minus Z by L into Z. So this is a starting point. Then when H is equal to L, MD equal to 0. So this at this point the value of MD is 0. Then consider the unit load in the last portion BC. Okay, from that we got MD equal to RA into Z. That means minus of a minus x by l into z. That means when x is equal to 0, md equal to minus az by l. That means at this point it is az by l, and when x is equal to a, md equal to 0. So this is the influence line diagram for the moment at d. Okay, next we have to find the influence line diagram for the moment at e. Okay, now first of all consider the portions AB and BE. Then we can simply know that M is equal to 0. That means for the first two spans, that is for the span AD and DE, the value of the moment at A is 0, so that we get a straight line only. From that, after that, consider the unit load in the portion EZ. Okay, that means we get the value of ME as minus 1 into Z1 minus X. Then apply the limits, that is when X is equal to 0, ME is equal to minus Z into minus Z1, and also when X is equal to Z, we get ME is equal to 0. That means when X is equal to 0, ME equal to minus Z1, and also when X is equal to A, ME is equal to 0. Sorry, when X is equal to Z1, ME equal to 0. So Z1 is the distance of this point E from the point C. Okay, so this is the influence line diagram for the moment at E. So you got the various values, various influence line diagrams for reaction RA, reaction RB, then the value shear force, influence line diagram for at the point D, and also the influence line diagram for shear force at E, and also the influence line diagram for the bending moment at D, and also the influence line diagram for the bending moment at E. So from by this problem, how to draw the influence line diagram for various reactions, bending moments and shear force, that you'd understood, and also try to solve the problems. Okay, thank you.